Welcome to the video. This is the fourth video on IRWCMS. In this video, we are going to have an overview of the zonal works contracts. Zone works contracts are zonal works contracts. Come, let's get into the video. Zonal works contracts, an overview. The aim of this video is to familiarize the user to zonal works contracts, engineering code references related to zonal works contracts, Indian Railway Works Manual references to zonal works contracts and the use of IRWCMS page for zonal work contracts. Zonal works contracts. Engineering Indian Railway Engineering Code by para number 1209 explains about the zonal works contracts. For administrative convenience, each division is divided into several zones with zone codes like A1, A2, B1, B2, C1, C2, etc. According to the engineering code, para 1209, contracts for zone works and engineering materials. It is often advantageous to allot all minor works and all works of repairs and maintenance in a particular zone for a definite period to one contractor. It may be likewise advantageous to make this contractor, who can be called a zonal contractor, responsible for the conveyance of or supply of engineering materials as and when required in a particular zone during a specified period. Again, engineering code explains about the works that are included in zone contracts. Zone contract includes new works, addition and alteration to existing structures, special repair works and supply of building materials subject to the contract value of each such work not exceeding rupees 5 lakh, all ordinary repairs and maintenance works, and conveyance of materials, example, conveyance of bricks, lime, sand, etc., which are likely to be required in a zone during the year. Zonal contracts, zonal works contracts. The zonal contracts is usually for the period from 1st of July of present year to 30th of June of next year. That is, zonal works contracts are given for on a yearly basis. The tender is called for the maximum value of the orders likely to be placed to execute various items of work in USSOR without reference to the total quantity of work to be done within a given period. That is, the tender will be called for a sum of amount, that is say for 30 lakhs, 40 lakhs, 50 lakhs, but we will not mention about the item that has to be carried out. However, a ceiling limit for the value of work to be operated in each chapter of USSOR is predefined, but still the administration reserves the right to change the ceiling in each chapter if required. The tenderer has to quote unit rates or prices for the rates as a single percentage covering all the chapters of USSOR. After the contract is executed, specific orders for work or supply may be placed against it. That is called as zonal work order. All works of the old contractor are completed by the end of June. Before commencing the new contract, all the old works have to be completed. As far as practicable, after the opening of the new zonal tender for the current year, approval of work orders over the zonal contract of previous year is not done, in other than exceptional cases. In some divisions, there is a practice of giving zonal contracts for specific nature of works like zonal contracts for water supply and sanitation, zonal contracts for horticulture, etc. And also in some divisions, they used to have non-scheduled items in zonal contracts also. That is for yield testing of bore wells, providing and fixing health faucets, supply of skilled workers, etc. Indian Railway Works Manual has two references in connection with the zonal works contracts. In para 224, under the heading Inspection Repairs, it says, a requisition for repairs and renovation works should specify the dates of previous such works without which work orders should not be issued. Planning of repairs should be based on the inspections carried out and should be completed well in time to enable the repairs being done under the annual zonal contract which commences from 1st July of each year. This excerpt has been taken from the GCC. GCC, they have specified the format for work order. In that, they have left blank spaces for filling up. Why I have brought them here is, once we look into it, we will know what are the data required to be filled up. That is, what are the data that we should be keeping it ready on our hand to prepare a zonal work order. Work order number, date, agreement number, again date, name of work, schedule of drawings, authority, allocation, and then we have the contractors are hereby ordered to carry out the following works at rates, and all these things are given. And then we'll be giving the description of item of work, approximate quantity, rates, etc. And we'll give them a completion date. That is, the work has to be completed on or before so and so date, and it will be signed by the competent person. So before preparing a work order, we need all this prerequisite data on our hand. That is, before you make your work order, we should know our zone code. Then we should have a draft work order number, a date for that draft work order, name of work, allocation, completion date. We should also have schedule of items and quantities. If we know the quantity of each item of work, that is fine. Then we should have a rough sketch. If it is applicable, we shall make a rough sketch, and it can be uploaded in the IRWCMS module. Then we should have remarks and or justification for the works, justification for this work order, date of previous such works. This has been told by IRWM. And if there is any schedule of drawing, that also has to be kept ready. Present system of working of zonal works contracts. Prepared and signed by SSE or JE Works, submitted to ADN in duplicate for scrutiny and further processing consisting of work order requisition, rough sketch, justification for the works required along with the last date of repair carried out in the building. Draft work order. Scrutiny of, once we send a work order requisition to ADN office, ADN will scrutinize that work order, prepare a draft work order. It will be signed by ADN, it will be forwarded to Division Engineer for scrutiny and approval. After receipt of this draft work order, it will be scrutinized at the Division Engineer's office, technically checked by the CDM. After the checking is over, it will be approved by Division Engineer. Then once again, it will be sent back to Assistant Division Engineer. ADN will arrange for signature by the contractor. After signing by the contractor, copies will be issued to one copy will be issued to the contractor, and one copy will be issued to SSE JE Works. One will be for ADN office use, and one will be for division office use. Also, in some cases, five copies are prepared, and the fifth copy is for accounts use. Similarly, in preparation of draft work order, say work order requisition, in many cases it is being prepared in triplicate. For operating the zonal work orders in the IRWCMS module, as we have already seen, we need to get into the zonal work order module. There we have creation and processing. In that we have another submenu. In that, creation by SSE Works is there. We have to click on that, and from there we will be preparing the zonal work order. So the starting will be from here for zonal works contracts. This is the enlarged view. And again, whenever there is a variation, it will be also processed under this module only. And after completion of works, the measurements of works of that is the measurement of works carried out under the zonal work order will have to be measured, and the details have to be entered into the measurements module. So whenever we are working with zonal works contracts, we need to work in two modules, that is zonal work order module and then measurement module. This is the zonal work order module, this is the measurements module. In measurements, we will have record measurements as well as final measurements. This is the enlarged view. For creation of work order and variation of work orders, we use the zonal work order module. For recording of measurement of works under each work order, we use the measurements module. So we know what is a zone, who is a zonal contractor, what is a zonal contract work order, engineering code references related to zonal works contracts, Indian Railway works manual references related to zonal works contracts, and how to use the IRWCMS page for zonal works contracts. Save water, every drop counts. Suggestions are always welcome. Suggestions can be sent to a.s.ramchennai@gmail.com. Hope this video was useful. Thank you.